Assalamualaikum and hi everyone, I am Teacher Nisa and today we are going to learn something very interesting. But before that, I would like to ask you guys some questions. Have you guys ever seen this kind of drawing? Or maybe this kind of drawing? Or maybe this one? So this kind of drawing is called as realistic drawing. But what is a realistic drawing? A realistic drawing is a drawing that incorporates the concept of realism. Realism is an art style that focuses on making a piece of drawing that looks realistic and true to life as possible. So that's why when we look at a realistic drawing, it looks almost the same as a photograph. Other than that, realistic drawings can be in many forms such as portraits, landscapes, and still life paintings. Now, I'll pass this to Teacher Munira for us to learn about the history of realistic drawing.
Hi, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I am Teacher Munira. So for today, I will continue on the history of realism in art. So everything must have a start, right? So when did actually the concept of realism in artwork production started? Well, realistic drawing has been erased since the 19th century. Well, at first, Western art was dominated by the art style that often appeared artificial and somehow removed from a real life, which is the academic theory of history, painting, and high art, where the artworks were always expressed grandly. So, who created the term realism? So the term realism was pointed out by a French novelist named Chevreuil in the 1840s. So this concept was then exemplified in the artwork where one of his friends, which is a painter named Gustave Courbet, was among the earliest artists actually incorporated realism elements in his art. So I think that's all for my part. I will pass to Teacher Narisha. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum and hi everyone. Nice to meet you. I am Teacher Narisha. As you have learned about the brief history of realism in art, let's move to the next part, which is the basic skills that are needed in creating a realistic drawing. It is important to keep in mind that hand movement is very important. You should have the ability to control your hand to create lines, tones, and shades on your drawing. This is very necessary for you in order to master the skills that you will learn in the next stages of creating a realistic drawing. One of the hand movement practices that you can do is hatching technique, as well as creating circular motions on paper. It may be a bit difficult at first, but don't worry, practice makes perfect. Over time, you will get better and will be able to create a realistic drawing.